Where do you go to find great people for an incredible price to do one task at a time? From anywhere in the world, Elance.com. Check it out in this video.
The website I want to talk about today is one of my absolute favorites. Maybe these are all my favorites, it seems. This one's called Elance, and this is about working with a global dynamic team. This is about taking the work that you do, either personally or in your business, and using a global team who will do it task by task at a far higher efficiency, both financially and with time, than perhaps what you're doing now with full-time and part-time staff. If you're not sure what I'm talking about, take a moment to go to my website, timlevy.net, and grab yourself a copy of this one here called The Entrepreneurial Handbook. And this particular book goes into this whole conceptual story in detail. But right now, let's focus on the actual tool itself. In this case, the website Elance. So what is Elance? It's the world's perhaps largest database of freelancers online, as it shows you here. You can see they have 100,000+ jobs that are live right now. Within the last 30 days, they've put $925 million worth of work through this thing over the last few years, and they're made up of everyone from programmers through developers, designers, writers, marketers, whatever. If you want to search for them, you can use this top box here, and you can search for freelancers. Let's just do that quickly for something a little unusual. Let's, for example, look here for lawyers. So if I was looking for a lawyer, I would type in lawyer like that. And up would pop, as you can see, 1,300 active lawyers. Now, in this case, you can see I've got this guy here, Andrew Taylor, out of Australia, someone from Pakistan. Maybe I would like to be more specific and hire a lawyer in the US. So if I just click on these criterion here, enter the country, in this case, the United States, it will redo the search, and now I have 635 results, but they're all in the United States. And what kind of level of experience are we talking about? Well, I'm always amazed at just how extraordinary these people can be. Let's look at this guy. I've never met him before, Charles Markham. I'm right-clicking. I'm doing open link in new tab and just popping over to him. And you can see here, as I click on read more, this guy's $50 an hour. He was licensed with the IRS. He's obviously focused on tax, and he's got more than 15 years experience as well as a master's degree. As you can see here, finding fantastic people. So you certainly can search the freelancers database from everyone from bookkeepers to lawyers to, I've looked at private detectives recently, but the heart of this thing is people who are working online. So oftentimes it's designers, writers, editors, all sorts of people like that. So let's jump into this thing and see what happens when you log into the system and actually sort of the rubber meets the road and you get to work. So firstly, you'll need to create a join a free account. So firstly, you'll need to begin by creating a free account. It's as easy as putting together a, you can see here, I want to hire somebody. Obviously, you could also work, but I'm focusing on hiring. Give them your name, email address, a username, and hey presto, you have an account. In this case, I'm going to log into an existing account that I already have. And I come to my dashboard. This dashboard is showing me everything that's going on right now. Up here, this listed out are three jobs that I have going on today. I've got some comedy work going on with a writer called Joel, and I've got some design work going with a designer called Mary. And over here on the right, you can see that I've got no action required. Everything is going well, no messages waiting for me. And these things, this is an interesting little box here. This just shows you some standard things that Elance has sort of found to be helpful for you. So for example, here you can, the one I'm looking for here, that one there, protect your intellectual property. Here you can get sample documents, non-disclosure agreements and so forth, so that you can create a measure of legal protection with the people that you're working with. I've never had any problems there, just worth knowing that it's sitting there. And you can see here under reports, these are my last 6 months worth of jobs. You can see the by money, at least, I've spent the most of my money on animation, a lot here on writing, some design work here, transcription, and so on. But let's jump into how to actually get a job going. For that, you're going to need to click this button up here that says post your job. Let's click on that. So this is if you want to actually hire somebody. Well, normally what I don't do is go and sort of hunt someone down. I just post a job and let the people who are interested get back to me. You can see here it's asking if I want to use any of my past job posts as templates, which I don't, so I'll turn all of that off. In this case, I just we're going to do a example post based on something I did a while ago where I was looking for a writer for a video and I wanted that video script to be funny. So I typed in something, you can type in anything, but I'm going to say comedy writer wanted. And how do you then describe that job? Well, I like to recommend, again, this is in that book, The Entrepreneurial Handbook. I like to recommend you type three areas. You cover three areas: talent, experience, and culture. What they're talented in, how much experience you need them to have, and a little bit about the culture of your business so you find like-minded people. Now, I've gone ahead and prepared something else earlier, so I'm going to cut and paste that in. There it is, and let's have a little look together at what I've actually written. Let's bring that over here. Okay, good. So here's what I've written. Firstly, what am I looking for? I'm looking for someone fun and easy to work with on a series of short animations for a corporate client. These are conversion videos for a web video in the style of Grumo Media, which is someone whose videos I like. Once the scripts are written, we'll make them into animations. Each one is the story of a profile character with a business that is my client business being the answer to that scenario. So that's the talent I'm looking for, someone who can write that kind of script. Here is the experience I want. Ideally, you'll have a strong portfolio full of short scripts going to make me burst out laughing. A past maybe in improv, stand-up, and you'll have years of writing creds and maybe a television, film, and other published forms of credibility. So that's the experience I want them to have. And then in terms of culture, I've just sort of written this, you know, let's have a chat on Skype. I love to speak to people on Skype before I hire them to make sure there's someone I'd actually like to spend time with. So next, I need to select the category of work. You can see there's lots of categories. In this case, it's going to be writing, and the subcategory is going to be probably creative writing. It doesn't really matter, but you can see they've popped up some skills here. We can add some more skills. Maybe there's a comedy skill here. And it looks to me like they haven't written that one out. So that's okay. I can just type in comedy and it'll add that one anyway. So now we know we want someone to write me a script that's comedy. And here we come into the detail. What's the hour? Do I want them by hourly or do I want a fixed price? Certainly a fixed price and certainly less than $500. And then I've got some more options here. I always click on show and jump into them. Do I want this visible to the public? Yes. Otherwise, no one can see it. Do I prefer candidates from a certain location? Yes. I would prefer, in this case, North America. Australia's also fine, doesn't bother me. Okay, so I've got North America and Australia, and I'll post this job for, say, 3 days, and boom, I'm ready to go. Now it's asking me if I want to pay some more money. I've never needed to do that, so I click on no thanks. And now I basically post my job for free. It's just asking me to go through and confirm it there, which is fine, post this job. It's as simple as that to actually post a job on Elance, and it hasn't cost me a cent at this point. So what happens next? Well, firstly, my job goes live and they send me an email to let me know. But let's go and have a look at when I posted this job previously to see what actually happened once this job was live. So I'm going to now go back. You can see that job's now listed in my dashboard to a job I archived, which is to say a past job, which was the same job as that. That's where I sort of stole my copy from. Here it is. You can see I wanted a comedy writer. And here you can see under more detail, there is the job post that we just posted. So I did this obviously in April of 2013. Now here's what's happened that's interesting. As you can see, 19 proposals came back within the course of those 19 days. 16 from North America, which is where I said I wanted them from, and one from India, two from Western Europe. Down here, as we scroll down, is the listing of all of those different proposals. Lots and lots and lots. So the question is, how do you sort out which one you're going to use? Well, the great thing about this Elance system is it gives you all of these criteria here by which you can rank these jobs. So the first one is this guy's in Ireland. Well, that's okay. I don't mind someone who still speaks English as a first language. His rate, $25 an hour is his indicative rate. That seems fair. And this one here, under writing and translation, which is sort of his category of choice, he's got a rank of 6 out of 10. Now, actually, that's really good. He's done 9 jobs before and earned $4,000. That gives you a sense of what he's been up to. And he's got a rating of 4.9 stars. This is a pretty good guy. Let's move on. This guy here, Norith Soth, in the United States, a ranking of 10. He's a great guy to talk to. He's done 43 jobs and earned 16 grand with a 5-star rating. This means this guy is close to perfect. By the way, did you notice that these two people have both given me the amount of money that they want me to pay them, $164. They made that up. I didn't tell them. They made that up. In this case, they've both done the same. Why $164.38? Because it's $150 plus the Elance fees. That's why those they come up with these funny numbers. You can see I'm just scrolling down and down and down and down. Lots and lots of people to talk to. Now we come to the first guy I was kind of really interested in. Look at this guy, Peter Bartels, in the US, a ranking of 9. He's done 56 jobs, earned a lot of money. It's got some great rankings. And if you read what he sent back to me, he's sent me a little letter here, and he's attached some of his past, his portfolio, if you will, some of his past jobs. He's got a great price. And here you can see I started writing to him. In other words, I'm talking to him before I've hired him. And you can do that from the proposal by just clicking on this one here that says send message to this freelancer. So we started to have a little bit of a chat, as you can see. And I said to him, I think your scripts are great, but I'm looking for something funny. Can you send me something funny? And he wrote back saying, you know, maybe not. So I moved on from here, didn't accept him. Let's look at this guy, John C. I obviously thought he looked good. And we had a chat as well. And I said, could you please send me something really funny? He sent me something. I had a look at it. You can, of course, also look at their portfolio, which we'll do in a moment. But down here is the guy that I actually hired. Look at what we said. I said to him, and you can see we actually, now I hired him. We have a long conversation. But here I said, you know, could we change the price? Yes. And I know that what we did is chatted via Skype. Look at his clients, though. This guy's already done work for all these corporate clients, 3M, Coca-Cola, Campbell's Soup. So this guy had amazing experience and a really good rating. And I looked at his portfolio, or actually he sent me some documents here, and I got some scripts that I liked the look of. So when I was ready, I clicked on a green button that was here. I'll show you it up here. Select. And that's when I awarded him the job. Once we did that, we went into the, if you will, the Elance system and conducted our business using the message board and got the job done. So that's really how Elance works. And I just want to give you a little bit of general advice here on Elance as well, which is that when it comes to Elance, let me just put up something in front of us that's half relevant. Okay, it's just going to stick here. All right. When it comes to Elance, there's just, I have a little bit of extra advice for you. The first thing is that you don't have to hire somebody to ask them to do a little test for you. So when you're in that proposals level, let's go back there right now. I happen to be going to an archived job. And let's go back to that one. Comedy scriptwriter here. When you are actually in this level, you can ask people to do a little test for you. You can say, listen, here are all my proposals popping up there. You can use this thing here that says contact, send message. You can say, listen, I've got 20 people to select from. Would you mind doing a 5 or 10 minute test for me? Could you chat to me on Skype? Could I? And you can get tests from 2 or 3 people. Maybe if it's an editor, they could edit the first 3 pages of your document. If it's a designer, they could show you some examples of their work. So you can work at this level when the proposal hasn't been accepted to try and figure out who's best. And even then, you can hire people in parallel if you need to. So that's one of my pieces of advice for you. But really, Elance is as simple as looking at the criterion, connecting with some people, jumping in, hitting select. You then fund the job. Let's see if I can show you that. I think it might have taken that away. Basically, when you fund the job, what's important is that you are giving the money to pay for the job to Elance, not to the person, but to Elance. And that gives you a measure of confidence that, you know, they haven't taken your money and run. and gives them a measure of confidence that you can afford to actually pay them when the job is done. So I've never had any problems with the funding portion of this. I've always done very well there. So that's how Elance works. Hopefully that's given you a lot of information about how certainly to get your sort of first hire going, and then you'll start to gather information on your own. Again, if you need more information on the details of this, I've written a lot about this in that book I mentioned to you, The Entrepreneurial Handbook. It's here at timlevy.net. You can grab yourself a copy easily enough, either via Amazon or Blurb for, you know, $10 or $15, and get even more detail about how this works. All right, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you at timlevy.net and in the future. Thanks very much.